is Elizabeth McNally. I'm talking to you today from the American Heart Association Basic Cardiovascular Sciences session, where I talk today about genetic modifiers that can change the course of heart disease. Some of what I do is I actually take care of lots of patients who have genetic mutations that lead to heart failure or heart dysfunction. And one of the things we know from working with patients like that and their families is that, in fact, often the same genetic mutation is associated with a range of how it affects the person. So they may have cardiac disease earlier in life, they may have it later in life. And part of what we've wanted to ask from a research question is, can we understand the genes that change the path of that disease? Now, ideally, we'd like to understand the genes that can suppress the disease and make it not show up, but sometimes we identify the genes that actually make it worse, but that's still a useful pathway to understand. So most of our work began working with mice that have a genetic mutation that caused them to develop cardiomyopathy and heart failure. And using the tricks of mouse genetics, we can actually take advantage of different genetic backgrounds in mice and use those genetic differences to uncover what are what we call modifier genes. So our very first modifier gene we discovered is a gene called latent TGF-beta binding protein, which helps regulate TGF-beta molecules, which are very important for injury response. So part of what we've come to understand is that a lot of these modifiers actually regulate the way the heart responds to injury. And what's very interesting about this first modifier is that it actually points to some pathways that we might be able to exploit and develop therapeutics around. What's most exciting about this first modifier is that it actually was able to work in human patients as well. So while all our studies were done finding the results in mice, we then looked for variation in that same gene in humans, and we found that it did correlate with human disease. Now, many of our studies actually study these mice that have muscle disease and heart disease, so we actually looked to a human population that had both heart and muscle disease for demonstrating the effect of the modifier in humans. We now mapped a second and identified a second modifier gene, which again points us very much to the pathway of how cells repair themselves after injury. And so we found variations in this gene in mice that the mice can either repair the cells better or repair them less well. And so again, this points to a very brand new pathway that we previously didn't understand about how cells respond to injury. And we think this is critically important for heart cells and for muscle cells. One of the interesting findings is we're starting to understand how this injury pathway actually affects the right ventricle. The right ventricle is not as well studied as the left ventricle, which is the main pumping chamber of the heart. But the right ventricle has become increasingly important because it's involved in things like pulmonary hypertension and can be involved in many forms of valvular disease. And so for the first time, it gives us a good window on something that the right ventricle is doing and the importance of that. So long term, we hope that these modifier genes that we've identified will translate to humans. And we did that in one case already, and we're optimistic about the second case that that will translate to humans as well. And the other really interesting part of this is that we hope that this is nature's way of pointing out these pathways to us to say, hey, look here, and develop drugs around this pathway, so that ultimately we can slow the progress of how hearts fail. I take care of all sorts of patients and families that have genetic mutations that now tell them that they're at risk for developing these heart diseases. And what we want to do is capture that window in time where we know they have a genetic mutation, but before the heart has gotten bad. And if we can then intercede with our drugs at that point in time and prevent the heart from getting bad, that can really be a life-saving intervention.